everybody. Welcome to Kids Worship. I'm Addie.
And I'm Sophia. We are so excited to have you with us today.
Have you ever wanted to be able to pray? I mean, really pray?
Jesus' disciples wanted to be able to pray like Jesus, so they asked him, "Lord, teach us how to pray." Today, we'll hear from Brian Scott about what Jesus told them next.
But before we do that, it's time to jump up and sing.
There's nowhere you won't go, nothing you won't do, no place that I could hide. You're always in pursuit. I'm never too far gone, always in your sight. When I wait for you, you're always right on time. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. You have my heart, now and forevermore. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me.
Praise the Son, praise the Spirit. the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe for the souls of all who'd come to the Father are restored. And the Church of Christ was born. Then the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of old shall not kneel, shall not faint. By His blood and in His name, in His freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me.
Jesus had just finished praying when one of his disciples said, "Lord, teach us to pray." So Jesus told them, "When you pray, say, 'Father, your name be honored as holy. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves also forgive everyone in debt to us. And do not bring us into temptation.'"
Then Jesus told them a story. Imagine one of you goes to a friend at midnight and says, "Friend, let me borrow 3 loaves of bread because a friend of mine has traveled to visit me and I don't have anything to offer him." The friend shouts from inside his house, "Go away, my family is in bed. I don't want to get up to help you."
What?
Even though the man does not want to help his friend, he will get up and give his friend what he needs because he asked boldly.
Jesus told the story to teach the disciples about prayer. He said, "Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you." Jesus asked, "Does any father, when his son asks for a fish, give him a snake instead? Or if the son asks for an egg, does the father give him a scorpion?" Jesus said that fathers who are sinners know how to give good gifts to their children. God is an even greater Father. He gives the Holy Spirit to those who ask.
Jesus told another story, a parable, to teach the disciples to pray without giving up. In a town was a judge who did not care about God or people. Over and over, a widow went to the judge and asked him to protect her from wrongdoing. The judge did not want to help, but after a while he said, "I will give this widow what she wants so she does not keep bothering me." Jesus pointed out that the unjust judge did what was right because the widow did not give up. When people cry out to God day and night, will He ignore them? Jesus asked. No, He will quickly make things right. Jesus wanted His followers to have faith that doesn't give up.
Jesus taught us to pray. Because of Jesus, we can pray to God as a Father and ask for what we need. We can trust that God is good and loving, and we can count on Him to do what is right.
Have you ever wanted to learn to pray? I mean, really pray? Jesus' disciples had seen Jesus pray, and they wanted to learn how to pray as well. So they asked Him, "Lord, would you teach us to pray?" And Jesus responded by first giving them a model of how to pray, and then He gave them a couple of stories to teach them exactly what praying was all about. So He starts with what we would call the model prayer or the Lord's Prayer. Jesus gives the disciples an example of the kinds of things that they should pray about, and that's found in Luke chapter 11, verses 2 through 4, and it says this: "Father, Your name be honored as holy. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves also forgive everyone in debt to us, and do not bring us into temptation. See, Jesus was telling them the kinds of things they should pray about. First, they should thank God in heaven that He is their heavenly Father. And then they should honor His name. They should praise Him. Your name be honored as holy. Praise Him for who He is. And then they should pray that His kingdom would come. What does that mean? They should pray that what God wants to happen in their life, in the life of their family, in the world around them would come to pass. Lord, Your kingdom come. Lord, would what You want to happen happen? Would Your perfect plan happen in my life today? Then they should pray that the Lord would provide their daily bread, what they need, everything that they need, the food they need, the shelter they need, all the things that they need. Then they should pray, Lord, would You forgive us our sins? And Lord, would You help us to forgive the people that sin against us? And Lord, would You not allow us to be brought into temptation? But then Jesus takes it even further. He gives a couple of stories to kind of teach them even more about what praying can be all about. The first story He tells is of a man who has a friend who's going to go on a journey. So he needs some food, say 3 loaves of bread. So this friend goes to another friend's house and he's knocking on his door late at night. Hey, can you spare me some bread? I got a friend that's going on a journey. He needs something to eat. Well, the friend whose house it is yelling back to the other guy saying, hey, I'm asleep right now. My kids are in bed. Would you leave me alone? But Jesus makes the point, no, because this guy's persistent. He keeps on asking. This guy, even though he's just an okay friend, is going to do what the man asks. And then Jesus gives another story. He says, well, there's also a widow, and a widow's looking for justice. And she goes to a court, and the judge there, he's not even a righteous judge. He's not even a good judge. But because the widow is persistent, because she keeps asking and pleading with him, that judge judges righteously and gives her what it is that she needs. But then Jesus breaks it down like this. He says, those guys weren't even good. But your heavenly Father, He's great. If they'll give good gifts, if they'll do good things for those people who are asking, your heavenly Father will do so much more. Jesus puts it like this. Keep on asking, and it will be given to you. Keep searching, and you will find. Keep knocking, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, the one who searches finds, and the one who knocks, the door will be opened to him. And then he says, what father among you, if he's got a son and he asks for a fish, is going to give him a snake? Or if he asks for an egg, is going to give him a scorpion? If you then, you're not even as wonderful as God, will do those great things for your children, how much more so will your Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? So the lesson is this. Keep asking God. Keep talking to Him. Keep praying to Him, knowing that what He has for you is for your good, and it's for His glory, because He is a good Father. So keep praying. Pray the way that He taught, and keep asking Him, because what He has for you is good.
Alive. The empty cross, the empty grave.